Hello everyone, welcome to CFC Fan TV. This is my post-match review where Chelsea won 4-0 against Brighton away. Guys, I'm so happy about this. Me and Rory did a preview, and as you can see in the preview, Rory was a lot more hesitant than I was. He was a little bit concerned about the injuries we had, about our lack of form, about how messy the Norwich game was, and if we could just show some sort of, you know, old sign of, well, some new sign of how we used to play. And I knew, I was confident. I feel like that Norwich game was such a weird game for me. It was like we made every mistake possible, red cards, yellow cards, bad passes, shots off target. But in the end, we actually scored more goals in that game than we did in our previous three. So I really felt like that was the turning point, and we just needed that one goal. And I knew as soon as we got the one goal that the rest would start coming, and that's sort of what's happened, really. I have to say, the goal scored by Willian was out of this world. Not just the goal itself, but the lead up to that goal, the flick from Hazard, the setup from Batshuayi. Like, I just thought the whole thing was fantastic, and I've missed seeing us play that sort of football. I've missed seeing us play really, really good football. Super creative. I don't know if they practiced it or whatever, but I think the main thing to talk about here is that the formation had changed back. Why Antonio Conte has not been sticking to 3-4-3, God only knows, because it is our best. It is our best formation, and I think he's proved that ever since, you know, we changed it when we lose against Arsenal 3-0 year or two ago, whatever. And that has to stay, and I don't know why he changed it. My only concern is the only reason he's had to sort of switch back to that is because obviously we have injuries. I think Fabregas is still injured, isn't he? As well as Morata. So, or not Morata, he's red carded, but I think Fabregas is injured. I don't know if Gary Cahill still has got a little bit of something going on. But other than that, you know, I hope he sticks to it regardless of when Fabregas regains fitness or whatever, because I love Fabregas. I think he's a fantastic player. I think he's super creative, but this, you can't deny this formation. We kept a clean sheet. I think Willie started off a little, I'll say Caballero, because otherwise people tend to joke, but I think he started off a little bit shaky, and then, you know, again, we kept a clean sheet, and okay, fine, it's only Brighton. Yeah, we've now kept two clean sheets against them, you know, the Boxing Day fixture as well. They didn't really look like an insanely, you know, good team, you know, or even sort of a team that we should be worried about playing. But, you know, the things Eden Hazard was doing today, you can't deny they were all so scared of him the minute he gets the ball. And especially for his last goal, you can just see they all fear him, they're all worried. But I think the only way to really get around Hazard is to, you know, sort of stay on him. You let him run with the ball and he's going to score a goal, he's going to create you problems. And that's exactly what he did today. I'm sure all the fans are buzzing, and absolutely fantastic of Hazard to give his shirt to that little kid who held up a little sign. I think that's so sweet. And it just shows if you make an effort, you never know what can happen. So bless his heart. And he got his shirt in the end, which I thought was lovely. Yeah, so that on a side note, but I'm sure Antonio Conte is feeling a little bit more pleased. And, you know, going into our game against Arsenal, I mean, both, they won 4-1 against Palace, didn't they, today? But you know, that's 8 goals between both teams. And I think both have suddenly picked up a little bit of form, but I would say it's more in our favour because they're not having the best time at the moment, and I would say the fact that they did concede one goal today shows they're still a little bit shaky at the back, and we just need to make sure that we take full advantage of that. I want to see a 3-4-3 formation. I just, you know, I know it's Fabregas's old team, it's that his rival, and he seems to score a goal against them every now and again, but that's really not the way we should be looking at this. We need to be looking at our form as a whole now, and this game represents a very good team that worked. We were very solid. I saw no signs really of anything that I would be worried about going into our Arsenal fixture. So yeah, you know, I'm super, super pleased with that. And I knew the Norwich game was a turning point, and I'm glad everybody else sees it now. Yes, it's only Brighton, but you've got to look at the positives here. It's, you know, it's not a 1-0 win, it's not a 2-0 win. We've scored 4 very confident goals. Like I said, the first one was the setup towards it was second to none. So if we can show more of that sort of football against Arsenal, their defence won't be able to handle it, like absolutely no chance. And I think with Fabregas back out wide, I think that just makes the whole team, I think it's a better position for him even, so, you know, whether that means you have to leave Fabregas out or not, that sort of is what it has to be for me for the next game. So yeah, comment below, what do you think of today's game? Arsenal is next. I've got so many interesting previews coming up. One's going to go live tomorrow. I will touch on, I think I've got another video coming out tomorrow on a potential striker. Although we got four goals today, you know, we still have a sort of issue that our strikers aren't, you know, scoring goals. A great assist from Mitchie, nevertheless, but, and it was a fantastic team effort, but we do need a striker that can score goals, you know, because we rely too heavily on our midfielders to sort of put the ball in the back of the net. Anyway, so yeah, so I've got an interesting video coming out on who I would like us to sign as a striker this transfer window. And then I've got some really exciting Arsenal previews for you. The first one's going to go live tomorrow night around 7 o'clock, so make sure you tune in for that. And yeah, if you like this video, please click the subscribe button, and I can't wait. It's going to be a super, super interesting week, and I've got a bet on with Robbie, actually, 20 quid. So I need to be taking next 20 quid home. I could do with it, actually. So hopefully our boys keep this sort of form going, because I think this was a perfect, perfect start going into that fixture. And you know, to make sure that we get top four this season, hopefully second place, that's what we're going for, isn't it? So yeah, if you like this video, comment, please subscribe and comment below on your thoughts on the game.